There are three things I want to do before I die. I'm gonna do them, Lurch. Nothing's gonna stop me. Nothing.
I got this.
You still want to test that theory of yours? 100,000 will do me nicely. Let's do the job.
Which of these are we doing today?
That's up to you. I got exactly 35 minutes before I front Mackenzie about getting us those typewriters.
But what about Mo? I can't
handle
her.
Yes, you can.
Look, I know she's accepted me as your assistant, but that's only because you're here. I'm poison to her anywhere else in the prison.
And that's what we have to change.
Well, a fat lot of good walking out on is going to do.
You're her best mate and a damn good teacher.
I'll convince her of that.
Only you can win back her confidence. Come on, you can do it. You have to.
We got nowhere with her since Ferguson started laying into her, have we?
No, she's even regressed a little this last week, but...
Right. So, Mrs. Maxwell, the object lesson for today is to win back Merle's confidence, for her sake and yours.
Tom, I
Wish
can't...
Wish you luck with the typewriters.
She did it again, Tom. She's getting real mean. And where's Tom?
He had to go and try to get some typewriters.
Yeah, well, I'm going. No, wait. I'm not staying here with you. I want Tom.
But you want to learn, don't you? Look, we're going to do some more experiments
today. I don't want to. Tom's me mate, and I only do that with me mate.
I still reckon you're having yourself on. I mean, she's in Barnhurst. How's she gonna do it?
The old spider, you gotta be kidding.
She reckons she can get the stuff into us, then we're laughing. No worries.
Yeah, I know. She's the greatest dealer in the world.
Struth, I don't know why you two didn't get married.
I hate to get pushy, you two, but I'm running out of work here.
Yeah.
What's chasing you?
Nothing. I hope I just ran into the freak with me skip.
You what?
Good one!
Bloody hell, you're pushing your luck.
No way. If we're gonna get the bitch, we've gotta go for it.
Yeah, so-called top dog's done nothing.
Oh, lay off, Tucker.
Why? We haven't seen her for a whole bloody week.
What do you expect? She's sick.
Yeah, sick of us.
I'm getting real friendly with the freak, though, isn't she?
She's right, Alice. She's started bashing two girls since we heavied her. And we just sits around talking to her. Now, why?
Don't know.
Eh?
I said I don't know, so let's forget it, all right?
Now, Mail, do you want to exercise or not?
G'day, Miss Ferguson. Geez, I've been missing your smiling face.
Oh, cut the crap, Connors. Come on if you want to go outside.
Later, how about a cuppa first? Oh. No, it's okay. You sit. I'm feeling pretty good today. I might even rob a bank later. No bite? Don't tell me you've changed your mind.
Nope. I just have to be sure it's going to work. I have to think about it.
Well, how much time do you want? I've told you everything.
Now, the money is there for the last 3 days of the month, right?
Last three working days, and I don't want to get pushy, but have you had a look at the calendar?
Now, you get the money, you break the window, you hide the money.
I get copped. You go in next day, pick up the dough, and walk away laughing. No one will tie you in with it. I don't know what you're worried about.
Jenkins might. The way she hangs around here like a bad smell, even her pea brain will suspect something's going on.
Yeah, don't worry, I'll fix it.
You've got a lot of fixing to do if you're going to do the job. Even if I get you out of here, you're going to be on your own. Are you sure you're up to it?
Bloody oath! Especially with a quarter of a million sitting there waiting for me. Oh, I could smell it.
Excuse me.
This is Marge.
Martin. Martin Jackson.
That's right. I'm surprised to see you. It's over a week since I called.
With the message that Margaret was desperately ill. I remember.
How did you find out?
I phoned you back while I was waiting for the taxi. The officer on duty said there was absolutely nothing wrong with Margaret.
I'm sorry about that, Mrs. Marsh. Really, I am.
Yes, well, I'm here now. So let's forget about it, shall we?
Right. You won't be sorry, I can promise you that.
But what about Margaret?
Leave that to me. If you'd like to sign in over here, I'll have a look at your handbag and then to the governor.
Oh. Merle. Now, come on, you're being silly.
No!
Come on, Merle. What would Tom think if he saw you now?
You go and get him and I'll ask him.
I can't. Look, he's gone out somewhere and he asked me to take your lesson for him. Do you want to disobey him?
Oh, not me. You are, because I'm not gonna.
But I want to, Merle. It's just like the old times. Remember the fun we used to have?
Oh, I just remember you got me put in a loony bin. You ran away. You're rotten.
Please, I've already said I'm sorry. I couldn't help it, honestly.
Go away.
Not till you come out from under there.
Oh, I'm not gonna, not till Tom comes back. Rotten pig! Big fat pig! You can't mess well!
I'm sorry. I know you're trying to help my daughter, but she hasn't wanted anything to do with her family ever since she got in with that group at the university. I tried. I don't know what we did wrong. But she hates us. She's hurt Bill and I.
Mrs. too. Marsh. Myra got herself tied up in something she couldn't handle, but that was a long time ago. She suffered. She's paid for it. Let me talk to her. I'm sure I can get her to promise to say that she'll stay with you. She doesn't hate you, believe me.
I'd like to, Martin, but...
Would you like to talk to Margaret?
Yes, of course. But I know she won't agree to the visit. Why do you think we haven't tried to see her all these years?
I'll talk to her. Permission?
You wait?
Of course. But, Martin... I know you're wasting your time.
I don't think so.
He hasn't changed. Still the idealist.
Okay.
How about get a jelly bean out of this lot?
I'll bring a whole packet next time, I promise. Now, don't forget, you're scheduled for a chemotherapy session tomorrow morning. I expect you to be
forget
there...
It.
Pardon?
There's no way, Doc. I haven't felt this good in days. I'm not going through that again.
Rita, I told you to expect this after a week off the chemo. Sure, you're feeling great, but it's not the real thing, believe me.
It's good enough for me.
But it's not going to last. Look, I know the treatment makes you feel like hell, but there is a possibility we can halt the disease, or at least slow it down for a short time anyway.
I'm sorry, mate, but if I haven't got long anyway, I'm buggered if I'm going to spend the rest of it feeling like death just because of some treatment.
Well, it's your choice, of course.
Yeah. And don't worry, I'm not going to throw in the towel. Going to fight the bastard to the end. Me and the Big C. Hell, I can run a book on it. You want to lay the odds, Doc?
I gave them to you last week. But work on it. You can certainly lengthen them.
Feel a hell of a lot better without that bloody chemo, too.
Well, if you change your mind...
Oh, no way. I've thought long and hard about it. And just in case I do lose this one... There are things I've got to do before the motor gives out. I can't do them puking me guts up, can I?
No. No, it's all right, I understand. I won't put the pressure on. Okay, Rita, see you soon. Keep smiling.
Well, don't worry, Doc. I'll be laughing all the way to the bank.
There are other treatments she could try, aren't there? Ones that wouldn't have such a drastic effect on her.
Yes, but it's six of one, half a dozen of the other as to whether they'd help. No, in her case, I'd say she's made the right choice.
What do you mean, in her case?
She has very little time left, Mrs. Reynolds.
But she's strong. She has the will to live.
She certainly has. And sometimes, with some cancers, that's enough. But with lymphoma...
I feel like a cigarette and I don't even smoke.
You like her, don't you?
Yes, yes, I do. The thing about Rita is she's tough, but she cares about people. She really cares.
Now, what's going on? I thought you said I had a visit.
You have. Now, just calm down, right?
In the governor's office. You bastard! You tricked me into this!
I merely said
you
had...
You knew bloody well I wouldn't have come if I'd known she was here.
For God's sake!
Oh, I knew it wouldn't work.
Well, why the hell did you come here in the first place?
To help you.
Sure. Like the last time. Well, you're not getting another chance to turn your back on me.
Please, Margaret, your father and I want
you back. No, my father and you hated my guts. You made that obvious enough in the past.
Margaret! Oh! I think I should go.
Yeah, what a good idea. Why didn't I think of that?
All right, that's enough. I'm fed up to the eye teeth with this.
Your mother has come here to help
you. No, I didn't ask her.
Yeah, well, you didn't ask me to risk my life to clear your name either, but I did. And what the hell for? So you can throw it back in my face? So you can stay here and wallow in your self-pity? And you, you're unbelievable. You've got an opportunity here, but you're too weak to fight. She needs you. Oh, what the hell? You both make me sick. I'll find another officer to escort you back.
He's wrong. I might have needed you once, but that was a long time ago. So you don't have to worry about me landing on your doorstep, okay?
Oh, I wasn't worried about that. I know you wouldn't want to. I know what you think of us. And that's the part I don't like. Because I blame myself. Yeah, well, let's just forget it, right? Oh, yeah? We could do that. Or we could talk about it. Please, Margaret. Please.
Merle is under the bed.
So how are you going to get her out?
I can't. You'll have to.
That's your job.
Which I've tried to do, but she won't have a bar of it.
So?
The girl is under the bed crying and will not come out for anyone but you. Do you want an officer to get her out?
No. I want you to get her out.
Look, you're a school teacher, not a bloody psychiatrist. Now will you please go and get Merle?
Why? Because you're giving up again?
Fed up to here with all this crap about giving up, okay?
It's not crap, it's the bloody truth. You've been giving up ever since you took your daughter's life. Why?
It's got nothing to do with you.
It bloody well has if it means I've got to do your work for you. Now why? Why did you fight to cope for all those years and then
give
up?
Because it was over. There was nothing to fight for after Linda died.
It was you.
So?
So, why didn't you fight for you?
Because I'm not bloody worth it. I killed my own daughter and I'm not bloody worth it.
What you did wasn't taking the easy way out. That took an enormous amount of courage. I think that's something you owe to Merle as well. Hmm? Screwing yourself up feeling guilty about Linda. You can't let yourself do that to Merle. You're always going to be more than just a friend to her. Not many people get a second chance for themselves like this.
Days growth off me.
Sorry.
Well, what's the matter with you? You look like your best friend just died.
Oh, big joke.
Yeah, well, if you want to cheer me up, you do better buzzing off.
That'd be right. Want to be alone with the freak, do you? Well, you call her Joni now.
Hey, what is this?
Well, you tell me. I've seen you, Reet. Well, one minute you're telling us to get her and the next minute you're chatting her up.
Yeah, well, so maybe I've got my reasons.
Well, what are they? What's going on?
I'm sorry, Lurch, I just can't tell you, mate. You're going to have to trust me.
Mate, that's a joke.
If you're going to carry on like
all
this...
All right, I'm going. And while I'm at it, I'll see a screw about shifting back to me door.
Yeah, maybe you better. Hell, who needs it? Go on, wreck off!
You come out, Merle, and you come out now.
Can't you get Tom? I hate it under here.
Well, come on out.
I'm not gonna. I'm not doing nothing for you.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but it doesn't make any difference. I'm still your friend, whether you like it or not.
Don't believe you.
It's true.
You don't stop loving your friends just because you've had a misunderstanding. You know that as well as I do.
Room service, leave on the champagne. Reed. Reed.
Bloody hell.
About bloody time someone showed up.
Been looking for Lurch.
Oh, Grange, she's probably out looking for you. No wonder we never get anything done.
Since when have you been a quiet achiever?
Just get the stuff out of the dryer, will you? I'm running out.
Thanks, Brum. I'll take over for a while.
Oh, good. Another entry for the happy smile competition. This motel finally getting to everyone, is it?
McPherson wasn't looking too blue. She's nearly wetting herself in the corridor. Where they taking her?
Got a visitor. Got to hand it to Vic. She knows how to get the best out of life in this dump.
Lisa, you okay?
Oh, it's just that time of the month.
Oh, shut up, Brumby. Look, why don't you take a breather? We'll cover for you.
Got to talk to you, Alice.
Oh, shoot.
Private, outside.
You got it. Look after the press, Brumby.
Look after the press, Brumby. Shut your mouth, Brumby. Stand on your bloody head, Brumby.
It's a nice day for a walk, Lisa, but... You said you wanted to talk. What's wrong?
You tell me.
What are you on about?
Rita, I saw those books she's been reading down the flat.
Well, it's just some...
She's got cancer, hasn't she?
We better be getting back. Come on.
Cut the crap, Alice. She's me mate, and if that's why she's sick, I want to know.
She's not even talking to me. I've even moved me stuff back to the dorm.
If they fix her, can't they?
She's dying, Liz. No one can do bugger all.
McPherson! You bloody idiot, I could have been Ferguson!
Nah, your head's not big enough.
Yeah, well, I'll knock yours off if you smoked all of our profits. Now, where's the rest? That's $60, you greedy bitch!
Not me, babe.
Oh, what do you reckon? Your visitor took a cut, eh?
Spider. Give her the economy for 5 minutes, we'd be exporting sunnies to the Poms.
Well, come on, we're down on kitchen duty this Arvo.
Oh, gotta work this out first.
Look, we'll give them the joints already rolled. That way we can spread them out thin, make a couple of bucks anyway. Cookie. Yeah, I can see that. Now let's go! Cookies! That's what Spider do. Make them up into hash cookies. Oh, get off. You'd waste them doing that.
Depends on how many you make and on how much you put in.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah. And on whether or not you put in any at all.
I thought you said you were smart. They're not going to fall for that.
When they see what good stuff it is, they'll be queuing up for miles.
I reckon I'm walking it first.
No. Now, come on, girls. We've got the tea to organise.
Oh, please, Mervyn, they're for Rita.
Yeah, there's something to cheer her up.
Rita's on a special diet, so the more reason why you can't.
Oh, Margaret.
Oh, hang on, got an idea. Hey, Merv.
Oh, Mervyn,
would you stop tea?
I haven't got time.
No, listen, we still want to do it for Rita, so why can't there be health visits? You must have a rest from somewhere.
Well, maybe. Look, there's too much to do
yet. Oh, come on, Mervyn. You've seen how down Rita's been looking. We just want to do something to show her that we're thinking of her. We'll make up for it time-wise, promise.
Well, all right. But you'll have to be quick, and I'll be supervising to make sure you do it right.
No worries.
There you are.
Why did you leave me behind?
Because I had to make a decision very quickly, and it was the wrong one.
You're never wrong.
It might seem that way, but
Just because a person uses big words and knows lots of things doesn't mean they're always right. If I'd fallen over and hurt my ankle, you wouldn't have left me behind, would you? In that respect, you're a hell of a lot smarter than me.
So, we've got things to teach each other.
Lots.
I missed you, Kath.
I missed you too.
I still love you too.
I know.
You know what else?
What?
I'm real hungry.
I'm really hungry.
Oh, what are we waiting for? Let's go and get lunch.
That you watch it. I'm too hungry.
$3 a pop.
Yeah, go for it.
Are you sure you mixed it in? I can't see it.
Well, I'm going to sprinkle it on the top. That way they can see what they're getting.
Well, give it here, I'll look after it. Hey, we having that for tea. It looks real good.
Not for tea, Mel. These are extras.
Extra specials, you might say.
I'll help.
Take it easy.
Knock it off, will you? I'm only helping.
Look, tell you what, Mel, don't help.
And we'll each lick the ball, okay?
Yeah?
Okay.
What? Bloody hell, there goes our profit.
Yeah.
What's so funny? It's your dough too, remember?
Yeah, but I reckon we'll get our money's worth. She's gonna be off her face.
Oh, hey, I just heard. Oh, she's given away a bribe. It must be true.
It is.
It's terrific news. All those hassles weren't for nothing, eh?
Doesn't look like it. No. And thanks, Lisa. You and Marty have been...
Oh, there. She's calling him Marty now.
An Ooh. Old friend, Alice. Don't go making anything of it. Mags are yours, Lee.
Ta. Look, do us a favour before you go and go and see Rick, will you?
Yeah. No, go. Her temperature went up and she had to see Sister Hall. Look, she won't mind if you don't make it. We'll say goodbyes for you, Spike.
Okay. I would have liked to have seen her, though. I mean, she's me mate.
Well, we'll see what we can do, but I wouldn't count on it. See you before you go, okay?
Yeah, no worries.
See
you. Jeez, Lee, she nearly blew it.
Look, she's going. What's wrong with letting her know one of her mates is dying?
Because she's got her own problems.
Oh, Alice, I just can't handle Reed going.
Oh, I know. We're her mates, whether she likes it or not. And we've got to hang in there, okay?
Okay.
Ta. Oh, g'day, Mrs. M.
What are you doing here, Jenkins? You're supposed to be at work.
I've got a big favour to ask you.
What is it?
Well, could you loan me 20 cents, please, Mrs. M?
What? 5 cents for the phone. Now, I'm sorry, Jenkins, if you've run out of
Oh, no, it's for Ruth. Well, she needs someone to visit her.
Well, why doesn't she make the call?
Well, because she doesn't know she's getting one yet. Oh, it's to buck her up, Mrs. M. She's turned into one of those recluses. She doesn't even want her mates around her.
Since when?
The last couple of days she's been going off. Please, Mrs. M.
Well, all right. But do it here and we'll make it an official call.
Oh, thanks. You won't tell her
no,
it's a surprise.
I won't. Just hurry up. Yes, can I help you?
Hudson, to see the governor.
Ah, yes, we're expecting you. Would you just sign in over here, please?
Oh, g'day, Ide. Yeah. No, I can't talk any louder, you silly bitch. It's Alice. Lurch!
No, I assure you we do need the typewriters. I realise Mr. Lucas does have an unorthodox approach, but he... I know, I'm sorry. I forgot to give him the forms. My fault entirely. Yes, of course, I'll get onto it straight away, and thank you. Gail, could you get Meg to... What? Thanks. I've just arrived.
Come in.
Mr. Hudson from the Premier's Department.
How do you do? Anne Reynolds.
How do you do?
Please sit down.
Oh, yes.
Earlier than we expected.
Yes.
Oh, would you like a cup of coffee?
Later, perhaps. I think first we'll get down to business. Your report on prison reform.
Yes. I must admit, I didn't expect such an immediate response.
I understand. After all, you do work for the department. Now, this is only preliminary, of course. The Premier was most impressed with your proposals. He asked me to come and make a further assessment of the situation before he comes to any decision.
I see.
And also to get Mr. Dwyer off his back. You certainly know how to tread on your superior's toes.
I realise I shouldn't have gone over his head, but I felt the quickest path would be the best.
And not always, Mrs. Reynolds, not in politics. And that's what we're dealing with here.
But we all have the prisoner's interest at heart, don't
we? Well, that's what I have to find out. You see, according to Mr. Dwyer, you're making much ado about nothing merely for your own promotion.
I can assure you that's not the case at all. God, I've been trying for years to get the minister to listen to
me
regarding
the reforms. We understand. Now, what I would like to do is to have a general tour of Wentworth so I can best judge matters for myself.
Of course, that's no trouble at all. When would suit you best?
No time like the present. And then I'll know I'm getting the true picture, won't I?
So you did it.
Thanks to you.
Oh, not entirely. Everyone needs a gentle prod now and again.
Or a good kick. You were right. I do feel guilty about Linda, not knowing whether my motives were unselfish.
Probably why you put yourself in the firing line in here. Come on, you lot, beat me up. I'm bad. I killed my kid.
Knock,
here she is.
Knock.
We'll get somewhere.
I said, knock, knock. Hey, knock, knock.
Hey, come in.
You're supposed to say, who's there, you knock?
Oh, well, that's not nice.
Yes, it is. He's a nice knock.
No.
Oh, look. Salt and pepper shakers haven't been put out. Our bag's doing it. Come along. Make a song.
Very good, Mel. What about your lesson?
Oh, no, I've got to do this first for Mr.
You OK?
Oh, I got a numb bum. Look, have you taken anything? Yeah. 3 carrots. You want one donkey food? A nong.
Donkey. No, Mel, listen to me. Drugs. Have you taken drugs or anything like that?
Of course I haven't. You want? You want salt? Me a carrot?
Oh, hang on. I've got something for you.
I've got to go and my mum's waiting for me.
Oh, geez, come on, Spike. Have I got the pox or something? Any? Sort of it, and I'm sorry, prison, you know? Because I am Spike. I really am. Oh, geez, come on. Okay, I'm a selfish bitch for what I did. But I want to make it up to you, starting now.
What's this?
Well, it's hash, you dumb mole. Me and Vic got it in good, eh?
Stick it, Brumby.
Well, what's up?
You've got a pretty weird way of showing friendship.
You know bloody well I'm off drugs.
But this...
Any sort. How do you want me to blow my appeal?
Yeah, probably. You didn't give the stuff when Maxwell fed it to me, did you? Always too bloody anxious to get out yourself than worry about anyone else.
Spike! Spike, hell, I'm sorry. I didn't think.
Yeah. Bye, Brumby.
Tom Lucas, Mr. Hudson from the Premier's Department.
Ah, so you are the new teacher. Mrs. Reynolds speaks highly of the progress you've made.
Oh, good. Be even better if we had some basic equipment.
Oh, these things take time.
You'll be glad to hear the typewriters have been approved.
Yeah? Worked hard on that one.
Yes, so I gather. I think next time it'll be easier on all of us if you went through the proper channels.
Takes a month of Sundays.
Where have I heard that before? Look, it sounds like your class is getting a little out of control. Shall we...
Well, actually, we're having a little...
I'm not with you, Ned!
you, Merle. I knew you'd balance them if you tried hard enough.
Come on, it's time to go back to the dorm.
No, don't.
What are
you? Off you go. There's a good girl.
Beautiful dog. What are you doing? Cut her off. What?
She just loves her lessons. We can never get her to leave.
I'm hungry again.
Because you're stoned, Merle. Gonna tell us where you got it from?
She can't be.
Get my next paycheck on it.
I'm not hurting at all, so I get all your money.
Merle, where did you get this stuff from?
You know, I hope I'm not going to get into trouble. That man was real cranky.
No, of course you're not. I'll tell him she forgot to take a tablet or something.
That'll be a big fib, Tom, because I did take them.
What else did you take?
Nothing. You're sure I'm not in trouble?
No. Just try to remember. Did someone give you a lolly or did you smoke a cigarette?
I hate them things. I like lollies. I wish everyone stopped talking about food. Oh, no. I forgot to lick the Vicky bowl.
You what?
Vic and Brum said if I didn't help them, then I could lick the bowl, but then I ate that funny stuff and I might.
Now, just a minute. What funny stuff?
The stuff that wasn't like chocolate at all. They were real, real cross when I first did it. And then we all started laughing. And that's when I must have forgot to lick the Vicky bowl.
The funny stuff.
Those bitches.
Oh.
What's the matter?
Oh, I feel funny.
I'll get a bucket.
No, come on, quickly.
Ooh.
Come on, over to the sink.
Oh, jeez!
Don't be silly, Tucker. They're going into the bin with the rest of them.
No!
Yeah, we worked bloody hard on these.
They smell.
They do not.
They do, and I'm not going to let you give them to Rita.
Look, she'd love them, I'm honest. Anyway, all health food stinks here.
Not like that, it doesn't.
Well, Robbie and me will eat them.
Mrs. Pringle? Oh, Mrs. Randallson, of course not. It's just a recipe that didn't work. It happens sometimes.
Oh, he's just too fussy, Mrs. R. We reckon they taste great.
They're going into the bin now.
But they took it.
Do as Mr. Pringle says.
What's all this noise about?
Oh, I'm sorry, Governor. Miss Ferguson, would you take Tucker and McPherson to the dining room, have them clean up? There's been a bit of a mess made. Oh, you heard.
I do apologize for that. It doesn't happen often.
Mr. Pringle, this is Mr. Hudson from the Premier's Department.
That's Mrs. Pringle.
And Miss Ferguson, one of our senior officers. Pleased to meet you, sir.
How do you do, Miss Ferguson?
Will that be all, Governor? Yes, thank you.
Mrs. Reynolds, if you have things to do before you join the ladies for their evening meal, perhaps Miss Ferguson would be kind enough to act as my guide. I'd particularly like to see the new reward cell.
Of course, one of the first things that must be done before any more of these reforms go through is to tighten security. Now, you wouldn't notice it, this being your first visit here, but security is a problem. Only 1 week after the phone went in, we had an escape. 1 week, and it was a trustee. I am delighted that the Premier has seen fit to send someone in to get the true picture.
Yes, he's very thorough. Miss Ferguson, it seems to me that you doubt your governor's ability.
Oh, no, don't misunderstand me, Mr. Hudson. I'm sure that everything Mrs. Reynolds does, she thinks she does for the good of Wentworth, but it is a problem when staff come from social welfare backgrounds.
Really?
Yes, idealism is all right in its place, but these women are here to be punished for their crimes against society, not to be pampered and petted. When you put trust in them, they abuse it. They don't know the meaning of the word. I mean, with their backgrounds, it isn't surprising. Mm. Now, I think that just about covers it, Mr. Hudson. If we were to go through...
Oh. Hello, Fergie. Oh, good, you made me day. What's the good of going to the zoo if you don't see the resident gorilla?
That's it, Brown, or we'll have to go back.
Oh, get on with you. Go on with you. Know I was only joking, don't you, Miss Ferguson? Hello, love. Arden Brown at your service.
What's she doing around here?
Afternoon, Mrs. Brown.
I never got to tie the knot, love. Never made no difference to me love life, but...
The governor's allowed her in to visit Con.
Take her through and keep her away from the others.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
You're going to be around for a while, love, because I was wondering if I could get a bit of a lift home.
Now!
I'm sorry, Miss Brown, I will be around for a while yet.
Oh, I see. Oh, well, them's the breaks. Ta-da, dear.
See what I mean? The governor slackens the rules, and once again, we are treated with nothing but contempt.
Get off your bum, you old mole.
Ida, what the hell are you doing here?
Oh, well, Lurchie rung me up and Annie gave me the go-ahead. She's getting a bit slack, isn't she?
Yeah, it's good, eh?
What are you gawking at, mug? Go on, nick off. Gov said we could be by ourselves, remember?
I'll be outside.
Outside the security gate, you, or I'll lag on you. Go on, beat it. Goodies, this isn't looking bloody to it, isn't it?
You've still got it, Ida.
I believe you got it too, love.
What?
Cancer.
How the hell did you find it? It's a bloody bitch lurch,
wasn't
it?
Now, hang on, Ev. Don't you go talking about your mates like that or I'll tan your backside for you.
Yeah?
And that's not the only thing I'm mad about. What's this I hear about you chumming up with the freak? God, I nearly had a heart attack when I heard.
Lurch has got a big mouth.
Now, she's your mate. And she cares about you. And Rita, God knows you need your friends when you've got a fight on your hands like you've got.
You reckon I'm going to lick it, do you?
My bloody oath, or I want to know why.
Well, don't you worry, Ida. I've got it all under control now.
Yeah, I'm sure you have. Love, excuse me, I've got a bit of a bloody cold. And don't think I'm blubbering over you neither.
You rough old tart, I wouldn't dream of it.
And a bit of bloody respect, if you don't mind.
I love you, Auntie Ida.
Oh, no, don't start that again. Now, you remember what I said. You ain't going to do yourself no good by shutting yourself up down here with only the freak for company. I don't know what's got into you.
I just needed a bit of time to sort myself out, Ida, that's all. Lurch understands.
She don't.
All right, then, I'll make sure she does.
Soon?
Oh, nag, nag, nag. I don't know why I bother with you.
Now, you hang on a minute.
All right, Ida. You're right. I have been a bit rough on the old lurch, but I'll fix it.
When?
As soon as you leave.
Ah, oh, that's my little baby, Rita. That's my little girl. Oh, bless your heart, love. I love you.
Stop you whinging, will you? It's hurt me more than hurt you.
Yeah, and it's all bloody previous time. At least you're getting your dough back.
Yeah, and all we got for our troubles is troubles. And you will be back.
You and your bloody cookies, if we thought them straight, we'd still be in business.
So now it's all my fault, is it?
I didn't hear you say no at the time. Now all we've got to do is work out how to pay Spider.
Geez, I'm glad she's in Barnhurst and not here.
Yeah, well, that's not going to last long. She's got connections.
Yeah? Well, maybe we have too. Hey, Lise. Hey, Lisa, you devil.
Back up and leave me alone.
Ooh, what's up, you?
Leave me alone.
All right, I want some answers. Did you give drugs to Merle?
Of course we didn't.
Don't lie to me, Tucker. Merle's stoned, and I heard that you two made some very special biscuits.
Don't started. Come to bounce with us, Maxwell. Looney got stoned because he's a green bit. Got him in the stomach.
Do you think we enjoyed watching her wolf down our profiteurers, man?
That's not the point. You broke the rules. You know drugs are out.
I was trying to get him
not only put
this
Tom's job on the line, but all the
new... Hang on, lady. You only take that sort of talk in the top dog. Just stop it! I don't know how Rita's put up with you for so long. She's told you over and over again we're going to stick together, and the minute her back's turned, you're breaking all the rules and you're just fighting like animals. You don't deserve her. You're so sick. And you're so selfish, I haven't even noticed.
Yes, did him still mind me all about it?
Just die, you stupid bitch!
Steady on.
Yeah, well, don't worry about it. I guess they all had to know sooner or later.
Is it true?
Yeah, but so what? I'm not dead yet, am I? And I'd just like to say I don't want any of you fussing over me, okay? Yeah, okay.
Real hungry tonight, Kath. My tummy's rumbling like anything. There's Rita! How are you feeling, Rita? Are you better now?
Oh, I'm feeling pretty good right now, Mel.
Oh, beauty. I'll see you after I get me tea.
G'day. Why don't you take the weight off your feet? Oh,
thanks, Rita.
I'm sorry about it.
Hey, here are the manis.
This is Mr. Hudson from the Premier's Department. He'll be joining us for dinner.
Hey, have I got you to thank for your visit from Auntie Ivy?
Sort of. I thought you need to be cheered up a bit. The Ida always puts me on the right track.
Yeah, well, you get real good food.
After carrying on the way I did, I had to do something.
Geez, I'm sorry, Ray.
I am too. I was just feeling a bit sorry for myself there. Trust me, Lurch. Everything's under control. And another thing, too. I don't want Merle to know.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll fix it.
You mind if we join you?
Not at all.
That's real good.
Hey, if you're not going to eat all your chips, can I have some?
Certainly, you can have some now. And what's your name?
Kath Maxwell.
Oh, yes, yes, you're helping Tom Lucas, aren't you? Enjoy teaching?
That's a little more stimulating than working in the laundry.
Are you a teacher on the outside? What did you do?
I was a housewife.
And before you married?
If you don't mind, I'd really rather...
I'm not really prying, Maxwell. I'm just trying to ascertain where your interests lie.
I have only one interest now, Mr. Hudson.
And that is?
To survive.
But surely...
And not just as a human being. I mean survive.
I see. Now, you found adjusting to prison life a little difficult. Do you have any views on the proposed reforms, Maxwell? I'd be very interested to hear them.
Well, in my dictionary, reform means better, so they would have to make life a little easier, presumably.
You're holding back. You tell me what you really think.
I don't think you'd enjoy that.
Try me, Maxwell. Come on.
The name is Mrs. Maxwell for a starter, but...
No, I do apologize.
I don't remember her very well because she has nothing at all to do with the person I am now.
Are you saying...
I'm saying that you're stripped of everything once you walk through those gates, Mr. Hudson. Your family, your friends, your identity. So you start from scratch, looking for something, anything to hold on to. And that's not easy because there's nothing. Only the bond that we form in being in it together. Is it any wonder you have murder and riots?
Mrs. Maxwell...
We need something. Anything to make us feel like human beings again so that perhaps we can finish our sentence as whole people. Not animals.
Don't you think that's a little strong?
Not strong enough, Mr. Hudson. Reforms are needed, yes. But for many, they'll be too late.
You must realise the women live under a considerable amount of strain. Kath Maxwell especially.
It's amazing, you know. I studied your proposals very closely, thought I had the gist of what was lacking, thought a practical tour would iron out any doubts I might have. But that woman got across what words on paper could never do.
Then you'll look into it.
Without a doubt, Mrs. Reynolds, and you'll be dealing with me directly from now on. We'll push it through as quickly as possible.
You're not worried about Mr. Dwyer's toes?
We haven't been for some time, actually. Well, now, I must be going. Thank you for the enlightening afternoon.
Come on, Candace, wake up, wake up.
Oh, yes, okay, I'll go to bed.
That's not why I'm here. You're going to do the job tonight.
What?
Keep it down.
I thought we said it was going to be Friday.
I've changed my mind.
Oh, nice of you to give me some warning.
What was Ida Brown doing here today?
Oh, now I get it. You think I blabbed, do you?
Oh, did you?
Likely it's not the sort of thing she can keep to herself. Still just us. You still want to let me out tonight?
The sooner I can afford to get out of this place, the better.
Yeah, well, it's not going to be easy when those changes come in, will it?
Are you up to it?
Firing on 12.
Right, you'll need this.
What's wrong with your bloody keys?
You're escaping, Connors. Do it.
Fair enough. You keep knit. There's a turn up for the books, eh?
Here.
Busy.
Hurry it up.
There's no need to wait up. The squad has gone.
Just making sure.
We're running a risk. What if we're sprung?
I'll be stopping an escapee, won't I? Too much time, I'll be missed. Back here. It's the white Monaro down to your left. Remember everything we talked about.
Yeah,
right, we'll get a move on.
Wish me luck.
give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.